Hi, this is Pat from the Maine, and you're watching Best Fan.
What's up, Best Fans? I'm Sharon Bhella here, hanging out with Pat.
Hello, how's it going?
Of the Maine, and they're here in Toronto at the Danforth Music Hall for their show in support of their new album, American Candy. Yes. How has that been? It's almost been a month.
Yeah, it's crazy. We're having a great time on the tour, and it seems like people are singing along to the new songs and into the record and stuff, so we're having a good time.
So with this album, it's really like poppy and like happy sounding, which I love. And I heard that you guys recorded it all in the middle of like nowhere. Like you brought your recording stuff to like a house in the desert.
Yeah, we went out in the middle of the desert in Joshua Tree, California, and we got this crazy house. It's like a dome with an indoor pool and three hot tubs. And
I thought it was like a little hut.
No, it was a ridiculous house, and this guy like said that we could record there, so we did, and it was awesome. It was really cool. The house was like beautiful. There was a deck around the dome, around the top of the house that was like 360, so you could just walk around the whole thing and you look out and it's just desert as far as you can see, and we were just literally out in the middle of nowhere. So
most of the songs are a lot happier on this album. What made you guys kind of go so poppy compared to the other ones?
I mean, I think the circumstances in which it was recorded compared to the last one probably has a lot to do with it. The last one was recorded completely live and to tape, and you know, it was kind of recorded like you'd record a record in the 60s or the 70s, and I think to a lot of people, maybe that appears as like dark. You know, to us, I didn't think it was that like dark of a record, but I guess after hearing people say it, I guess it's a little dark compared to what we had done before. And then we recorded it with Colby Wedgeworth, who we did Pioneer with, and he's just a pop guy. He like the 90s like alternative pop rock is like his like favorite, you know, like Third Eye Blind and all that kind of stuff. So that's kind of where we can like relate with him on stuff. So I think those influences probably poked their head out a little bit more than they had the last record.
Cool. Okay, so since we're from Best Fan, I have to ask you, what would you say you're a Best Fan of?
Guy Fieri from the show Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. He's my angel.
Oh, cool.
All the best food.
Cool.